removed. I raise to move that the bill further to amend the National Investigation Agency 2008 as passed by Lok Sabha be taken into consideration.
Motion moved. Any member desiring to speak may do so, after which the minister will reply. The we will take up the discussion now. Start with Dr. Ashok Ashok Bajpai.
Very politic amendment.
Heard about it.
I agree with you.
2 hours will not suffice.
I agree with you. Let us start the debate. It has been brought to my notice even by leader of the opposition and also other parties also. I will keep that in mind. But first, let us start the debate. Enough time is, there will be some limit, but at the same time, more than 2 hours. I do agree. See, Dr. Ashok Bajpai.
Maniye Sabhapati ji.
Aap kuch bolna chahte hain, Amit bhai? Aap kuch bolna the cabinet minister want the minister of state to make a beginning.
Honorable speaker, sir, terrorism is a serious concern which is dangerous not to only India but to the entire world. Our government has a zero tolerance policy against terrorism. Various steps have been taken to fight terrorism, like reinforcing the intelligence setup, checking infiltration, capacity building of special police forces in the states, constitution of national security guard hubs, etc. Prior NIA state police used to investigate terror offenses. However, they faced constraints, especially in terrorism cases having international or interstate linkages. In aftermath of Mumbai attack 2008, NIA was created on 31st December 2008 by the enactment of NIA Act 2008. It commenced function from 19th January 2009. NIA has pan-India presence, being involved in investigations pertaining 26 states UTs. Presently, NIA has having 8 branch offices apart from headquarters in Delhi. These are Jammu, Lucknow, Kolkata, Guwahati, Hyderabad, Raipur, Mumbai and Kochi. Till June 30, 2019, NIA has registered 272 cases. Judgments have been pronounced in 51 cases, out of which conviction has been secured in 46 cases. Overall conviction rate is more than 90%. Our government is proposing amendments in NIA Act to further strengthen the legal framework to tackle terrorism. The object of the proposed amendments in the Act to facilitate speedy investigation and prosecution of terrorism offences, including those committed outside India in which Indian citizens' property are victims. Our government has zero tolerance policy against terrorism. In case there is a terrorist attack abroad in Indian citizens' property, flights, ships, our government will not spare terrorists responsible for that. Therefore, it is essential to empower NIA so as to ensure harsh punishment to such terrorists. The present system of appointment of judge by name causes delay in trial of cases, as every transfer of the judge necessities fresh appointment after seeking recommendation of the Chief Justice of the High Court concerned. Therefore, for the words, a special court constituted, in the words, a court session of designated as a special court, as a proposed substitute here, I will like to clarify that judges' special courts will be continued to be appointed as recommended by Chief Justice of High Court concerned. Only the process is being simplified to avoid delay, as our government wants to ensure that terrorists get punished quickly as per law. In the schedule, the following acts are proposed to be added: Explosive Substance Act 1908, as many times the explosive substance are used by the terrorist and such acts may need to be investigated by the NIA independently in future. Section 370 and Section 370A of a Indian Penal Code, which deal the human trafficking, to enable NIA investigate those offences, women and children smuggled by neighbouring countries transit through India. There have been several discussions on women trafficking in this August House, wherein honourable members expressed deep anguish. State police force difficulties in investigating human trafficking offences, as if these have international and interstate linkages. Presently, there is no central agency to investigate such crimes. Therefore, it is proposed to empower NIA in this regard. Section 25(1AA) of the Arms Act, as the terrorists sometimes use prohibited arms to commit crimes, and NIA is required to be empowered to investigate such offences under Arms Act independently. Section 66F of Chapter 11th of the Information Technology Act 2000, as it deals the cyber terrorism, which needs to be investigated by specialized agency like NIA. Cyber terrorism has become a serious challenge for the whole world. New ways of cyber terrorism are being involved continuously. Empowering NIA to investigate such offences will help in developing core competence in the regard and further strengthen our country against the threat of cyber terrorism. Honourable Speaker, sir, Honourable Chairman, sir, sorry, I request all the members to pass the proposed amendment unanimously to strengthen the legal framework against terrorism. This will help in speedy investigation and prosecution of terrorism offences, including those committed outside India, in which Indian citizens' property are victims. Moreover, it will be facilitate strong action against serious crimes like human trafficking and cyber terrorism.
The first time, new member, and then MOS. That's why sometimes we have to be a little liberal. That's all. Good.
Subscribe us and press the bell icon for more interesting updates.